Yismach Lev Mevatshe Hashem. This august body, an individual who just seeks out the Rebbeinu Shel Olam, already rejoices and celebrates. As was previously mentioned, Shusra Shishiva Shlita, Koshev HaTalmidei Chachamim, Rabbi Yaakov Salomon, Rabbi Zagatinsky, Samson, and all the others, Rabbi Milstein, who are here, and many others whose names I haven't mentioned. What's unique about this gathering is that you're all Mevakshe Hashem. And you're not just Mevakshe Hashem for your own little corner in the world, but you're beginning the B'ri HaTichon. There was a crossbeam that went from one end of the Mishkan to the other. Targum Yonis ben Aziel says that this crossbeam was comprised of the actual wood that Avraham Avinu had used as an eshel to bring in thousands of people, tachas kanfei Hashem. And I think the lesson is clear. The holiest avoda is done in the Mishkan and the Beis HaMikdash. There's a crossbeam to remind the Kehanim and the Klal Yisrael of the importance of chesed, of bringing yidden tachas kanfei Hashem. Talmidei chachomim marvim sholom bo'olam. Abchatzkel Aramsky Zatzal. What does it mean, talmidei chachomim marvim sholom bo'olam? Does it mean that you walk to a next door neighbor's home? I heard you screaming at your wife last night, I'm a Talmud Chochem, I have smich, I'm going to make sholom. Your children aren't getting along with the family, I'll make shalom. He explains the reason why people are angry and upset. It's because they lack a satisfaction in life. All the money in the world doesn't bring a Jew satisfaction. But a Talmud Chacham with his blood gemara has a simcha bal Yeshua. And that simcha sachayim overflows to his family, to his friends, to his community, to his city, to his country, to the world. That's Talmidei Chachamim Ma'am Shalom Ba'olam. And what greater definitive statement of B'ri HaTichon, what Talmidei Chachamim Ma'am Shalom Ba'olam, you, Mevakshe Hashem, that Baruch Hashem, I know many of you, B'nai Taira, B'nai Aliyah, Choshev and Mishpachas, that have incredible children. But your focus is to be the B'ri HaTichon, to remember that as you attempt to live your lives on Pitamas HaKodesh, with the Avodas HaKodesh, bringing Kobanis, being Mispalo, learning Torah, you realize that there's a B'ri HaTichon that runs from one end of our Avodah to the other. And I want to tell you a story that just happened with Moran HaGoyim, of Yisrael Belsky Shlita, the Omar Afu Shlita, the Kar of Bez Hashem. It was told to me Leil Shabbos, and I told it over to my Gila on Shabbos morning. Moran of Belsky is that type of Rosh Yeshiva, with the B'ri HaTichon, his love for Yidden, for Klal Yisrael, for Torah, for Shalom, overflows. He's hospitalized in New York in a hospital. And they made arrangements to transport him by ambulance to another hospital in Manhattan with certain specialists. And they're getting ready to take him. And Abelsky said, I'm not going. I'm not going because I'm in a frum hospital with frum doctors. I'm going to denigrate these doctors. People are going to think that I'm up to snuff. And they're going to think if I'm going to a different hospital to other specialists, it's a shame about their reputation. I'm not going. Half an hour later, Rebelsky went into cardiac arrest. The members of Hatzola told me, who were to transport him in that hospital, that had he gotten into that ambulance, he would have been lifted. And only because he was in that hospital could they take care of him immediately and bring him back to life. That is Talmidei Chachamim Ma'am. That's the chesed that we have ingrained in our very DNA. We feel an achrayis. What does it mean that you can make kiddush again and again and again? for someone to be able to have a lechayim again and again and again. But pashtus, if you've made kiddush and someone hasn't heard kiddush yet, you could be mitzvah. People don't know how to make kiddush. You could be mitzvah. How does that work? It's called arvus. Kol yisol ha'arim zebozeh. We're guarantors for each other. You know, the Achareidim explain this. It's not just that that person is piggybacking on my kiddush. If I make kiddush, I'll make somebody else. It means that as long as there are Jews in the world who have not yet made kiddush, I have not yet been yetzer lechiyuv. You made a kiddush with kavona, you drank a shir, it's gevaldik. You're not yetzer lechiyuv. If there's a yid in New York, or Muncie, Minneapolis, Memphis, Yerushalayim, who has not yet made kiddush, you have not been fully yotzi yachid. And that's how I could be yotzi every Jew in the world, making kiddush 1,000 times, because I'm making kiddush for myself. Consciously, subconsciously, unconsciously, you understand this. That's why you're here. Of course, delicious food, mesmerizing speeches over Shabbos, a boring closing right now, but at the end of the day, you are here because of the fact that you recognize that you're not fulfilled yet. And you begin to tell me that Chachamim are overflowing with Torah, with Chesed, with Yirah. I used to have been married to Israel many years ago. And unfortunately, these were deplorable times when individuals who were mentally unstable, they didn't have the facilities to treat them, to deal with them in a proper way. So they put him in a bet mishugayim, an insane asylum, a mishugayim. And every year, the residents of the mishugayim would come before a panel of eminent psychiatrists and psychologists to determine if they could be mainstream in the society. There's a specific fella who would stand there and scream, "I need no Molly! I need no Molly! I'm normal!" And they'd say, "Lo, tislach, I'm mishugayim, you're not normal." He'd go back to his room. This happened year after year, finally 20 years later. He says, "I need no Molly." And they say to him, "That's it. You're right. You are normal. You passed all the tests. You're ready to be mainstream in society." He's getting ready to leave, and they tell him, "Zechim lechto b'shmacha ishuv, petek. We have to write for you a certificate of normalcy." So they write him this in this day. Plenty been plenty. Been found by this eminent group of physicians to be normal, and we're releasing him from the home. Then and there he makes a kabbalah, accepts upon himself that yes, for 20 years he slept with Mishagoyim, he ate with Mishagoyim, he lived with Mishagoyim, he didn't have nothing to do with Mishagoyim. He will never be in the Dalai Lama's of Mishagoyim for the rest of his life. He gets all his things together in his suitcase and he walks to the nearest bus stop. And all of a sudden the bus comes, a naked bus. And he's about to get on the bus, and he remembers his kabbalah, and he says, "Nahan, tagidli, I can't omali. Driver, tell me, are you normal?" So the driver looks at him, he's a naked bus driver, he's used to all kinds of questions. He says, "Ani choshev kach. Ata choshev, ani yodea, ani yesh petek, eva petek." "You think I know? I've got a certificate of normalcy. Where's your certificate?" He's unable to produce the certificate. So he walks off the bus to the only safe place he knows, back to the Bet Mishugayim. Choshev b'nei b'nei saleh. The world today shrieks at the top of their lungs, "Ani normali." Alternative lifestyle. Incredible beyond anything the Gemara could fathom. Look in the Sefer Chulin Daf Tzadi Beis, one of the mitzvahs that the Goyim had, 3 mitzvahs, Ula says, and didn't write a shtar ksubah for abominable behavior such as this. When Hayit is honor the mayor, he's the Masada Kedushin, B'choy Be'Vatzma. They scream at the top of their lungs, "I need no Malik. If I pick it, Liyish pick it. It's the Torah Kedusha. We have a Torah Kedusha that gives us an insight, an understanding, a base of normal moral behavior. We don't have to be ashamed of this petek. We have to wear it proudly. You know, Yedidi b'chaviv, my beloved friend of Solomon, mentioned that Akuda, beautiful kibbutz Akuda, and a sifa for Rav Belsky, over 600 people came to say, tell him, Tebi b'chaviv, Zedrus, Shabbat for Shleimim, Yibol b'chaim, Ori v'rabi, Rav Chaim, Stoins, that's all, Shloishim, 800 people came, Evan of Benefilei, Lachim, 1,000 people came for breakfast. And a month ago, we had a Shabbaton for over 100 college kids. In the very same Akuda. There's nothing to be afraid of. It was an incredible, the Olam said it was like Simchas Torah. Dance Kabbalah Shabbos. That I'm asking to do it every week. But it was incredible. It opened the eyes of the Kehila. They had these college kids over for meals, for the Suddhas. I did Shabbos till 12 o'clock at night. And there are kids that are connecting now to our community. Every shul can do this. We're strong, we're powerful. We have Das Torah, we have Etzayin Hashem. It's a different Klal Yisrael today. And that's the mit Torah. We don't need gimmicks and games. It's the Torah nation. That's the godless of Project Inspire. I have an uncle here who's here for Shabbos. I'm not going to mention his name. He's in Talmud Chacham Mufli. He learns the entire day in Kail. And he's here for Project Inspire. Because it's not a stealing. What's this to stealing? He had a lot of orchem at home in Minneapolis. She deserved the carve to home flatbush. For Neumann. My beloved mother-in-law was the first to laugh. Al Kapanim, so we would have people come to the house for the first time. And I'd say the same standard speech. Our children are perfect. Every one of our three children are incredible, they're perfect, they never do anything wrong. But before the guests come, we tell them, we sit with them and we say, we don't want an eye, we don't want an evil eye. So we want you to act rambunctious like Vildachayas. He said, nobody will give you an eye on. And at that point, my wife, Rebbe, and Mora Vail would chime in, and they never disappoint us. That's all we have to do. They think that they're acting vil because of an eye on. Focus on your children, on your grandchildren. They love that more than anything else. It's not a time for philosophical debate, it's a time for gewaltige zmiras, divrei teure, gewaltige suda shabbos. It's a celebration of life, this thing we call Judaism. A friend of mine, Rav Chaim Foy, you know, I'll tell you, when you meet newly initiated, yin, they think of shabbos in one word, restrictive, prohibitive, claustrophobic. I can't go there, I can't buy that, I can't have a pastrami sandwich. Cardinal Pablo Zavdolas, he said yesterday on the radio that he knows enough to meet him. He's going to call me a sandwich and a pastrami sandwich. Even the cardinal knows enough to meet him. But yet, they don't want a pastrami sandwich. They want a pastrami sandwich. They want it now. They can't buy it. The store's closed. They can't nuke it in the microwave. It's prohibitive. So I tell him of a friend of mine, Rav Chaim Foy, who lives in Yerushalayim, went to the science museum. Space Museum, actually. Smithsonian Space Museum. And he saw the actual module that the astronauts flew to the moon. The quarters were so cramped. The instrument panel was inches from their faces. The seats were molded to their body contours. They ate through tubes. They relieved themselves through tubes. They feel they were claustrophobic? Absolutely not. They were soaring heavenward. They were flying to the moon where men had never gone before. That's what Shabbos is. Shabbos is not claustrophobic. Shabbos is freedom. It's real. It's exciting. And we all know this. And to share it with other Yidden. And of course there are rules. You ask your rov and you follow exactly how to invite and whom to have over. It's the easiest thing in the world, and it strengthens your Shabbos. It strengthens your kashrus, your shalom bayis for sure, because you can't argue in front of these people. So you know that for a good 3-4 hours, if you want to get along fantastic. You know what Kiddush is? The Briskerovs, that sound prior to World War II, many years before World War II. He said an amazing thing, Rabbi Shenavur. He said, either Yidden make Kiddush or the Goyim make Havdalah. Either the Jews sanctify themselves by elevating themselves, and in that way, they're distinct, unique, and separate from the nations of the world. Chas v'sholom, rachmona litzlan, the Goyim make Havdalah, they make a separation. Jews to the right, to the left, you're Jewish, you get on the train. We have to make Kiddush. We have to make Kiddush. And what does it mean to make Kiddush? Let me explain to you. Dashti b'soich b'nei Yisrael doesn't mean sifugim. Rabbi Isaac Sher, B'shem Yalf from Slavotka, explains that Dashti means not mitoich prishos, ela mitoich hashivos. Not because it's scary, it's terrifying, it's usher, because it's pastnish. Because we raise the bar. It's the heady days of summer. Having family over for a barbecue. And you have 15 rib steaks. Not the family pack thin jobs. I'm talking about the real thick rib steaks. The ladies know what I'm talking about. Having rib steak. It only costs $20 because I got this really skinny one. So I'm going grace the rib steaks. You're carrying your plan out to the barbecue pit through the mud, and a steak falls into the mud. It's all fashmutzik. Who knows what was walking there? So, mitayras rib steak, you can wash it off. The men know what I'm doing. But really, you don't wash it off. It's beneath your dignity. It's a pastnish. Moran Lyashiv Sita, thank you, Zoom. I guarantee you never had baby riblet lashes. You know why? It's not negeya. It's not because it's a halig mensch. It's beneath his dignity. Jews have to fly above the terrain, beneath the radar. That's what Yiddishkeit's all about. We can't get caught in the mud, in the brambles, in the thicket, tear your clothing, scratch your knee. You have to raise the bar. Our children have to be proud that we're hidden. And so we combat all the issues of the day. My Rebbe Noam Hagoyim before Shmuel Birnbaum Zatzal loved Americani Yidden. All Jews of all stripes go into the Mil Yeshiva. You think the project inspires the Siddish fellows? Half the Kohl over there are satin and bells with the Hajj Nazak and learning in the mirror. He loved Yidden. And he has to fight with Marav Shtem and Yibor Lachaim, which in the light, Amor Hashem. Shtem had said, what do you mean? Neibrak, Yad Sefer, Shalayim. And he said, no, Barapah, Flatbush, Muncie, Memphis, Minneapolis, those are the Hashem in the light. And I'll explain to you why. It's a word that was told to me by his son on the way to Kfur in Eretz Yisrael. I was there for the morning of Tamidim, we did the Tahara, then I flew to Eretz Yisrael, my Rebbe. I was Kaivra, I was masculine. Reb Shmuel said a gewaltig vot. And it talks to our door. It talks to all our challenges in life and how we can overcome it with what we have within our very essence. Yankov Avinu makes a startling declaration. He says, Eilech ve'areno b'terem omus. I have to go see Yosef HaTzadik before he dies. Before I die. If Yankov dies, you can't see Yosef. So he answered based on what the Bolchadim Zatzal, Hashem came down upset to the Bochum and Baranovich. The Bolchadim say, Chab the Reinitz, seize the day, carpe diem, run and go see the Chofetz Chaim. Because here in this world, you'll see the Chofetz Chaim. In Yenavilt, in the world to come where they understand who the Chofetz Chaim is, you may not be zecher to see. Said Reb Shmuel, this is Reb Shmuel Birnbaum. The Bechir Ha'avais, Ishtam Yeshiv Yehelem, the world's greatest master. He says, Yankov Avinu was Ishtam Yeshiv Yehelem, constantly living Torah. But Yosef HaTzadik faced the most difficult nisayon, more difficult, says the Medrash, than all the nisayonis of Avram, Yitzchak, and Yaakov combined. To the point that the Torah, Chazal, called him Yosef HaTzadik. He was under the nisayon. Elich Barana, the term Omis, who knows? When I come up to Shemayim, they'll allow me into the environs of Yosef. Because he's an Omis in the sun. I better go see him now while I can still see him. If Shmuel moved his door, the challenges that we face from the internet and everything else. But look where we're at. Sunday morning, Shalom Shavron would call Sunday morning, Shabbos Sheni Shalgolias. We're sitting, we're learning Torah, being mechazik ourselves. You're inspiring me to go out and to change the world with all the nisyonis that we have. Anachnu dor mitzuyan, we're an incredible generation. An incredible generation to learn Torah, to keep Shabbos. Aber nicht stamm, but Chofetz Chaim calls it the Shoyer Shabbos. With a gishmak, with anticipation. And to bring that to others. Elich Berenu B'Terem Omos, we have nothing to be ashamed of. I used to think as a kid, what are we going to do in Shemayim? You know, live through the Holocaust of Europe, the Spanish Inquisition, all the dangers, anti-Semitism, the gulag of the Soviet Jewry. What do we have to say for ourselves? We have a lot to say for ourselves. Because we're taking an achrayus like the Briah HaTichah to take care of Klal Yisrael. And that's what you're all about. And don't let anybody put you down. That's the eights of the eights of others to say you can't accomplish, you can't do. You don't have to be articulate, you don't have to be mesmerizing. All you have to do is care. With an overflowing heart, like that Tam Tachin, who's not B'Shalom Oilam. Like the Goyin explains, the consonant Mechanach is Mechanach with the overflow, Chaim Volozhin says. The Kais is so filled that it overflows, and it fills the Kais that's around it. That's what we are, the Siyata Dishmai. That's how it's getting to the next door. I apologize because the way the lights are, I cannot read my notes. It may be good for you or not. We talk about Kiddush. My wife, Maura Bela, is a nursery school teacher for many years. And as you know, every Erev Shabbos, there's a Shabbos party. The boys are the Shabbos Abba, Tati, Daddy, and the girls are the Shabbos Mami, Ima. And the boys normally take one of my old hats, and they put it on. It used to be a downbrim hat, now it's an upbrim hat. They take a face of tie, they nearly strangle themselves. And the girls, they put on a tichel and they get a bench licht, as they. So the boys make Kiddush. Yankiv, can I borrow my cup? It's right there to your left. Any cup. So the boys make Kiddush, and each one makes Kiddush according to the minhag of their father. Some boys stand, some boys sit, some boys stand and sit. That's how I make Kiddush. But there was a child in another nursery school. He got up to make Kiddush as the Shabbos tati. Picks up the kais and he says, "Boy, am I tired!" Because that's how he is not, he makes Kiddush. I said this story over in the Stolen Base members, and the Stolen Yaman comes over to me and tells me that his wife is a Mr. Benenet, a nursery school teacher, and she also had a story with Kiddush, but this is how it went. A little three-year-old boy picks up the kais and he says, "Mommy, thank you for setting the table so beautifully and making such delicious food. Kindle, thank you for inviting, dressing nicely for Shabbos. I hear it by inviting you, Mashishi." How do you want your children to make Kiddush? How do you want your grandchildren to make Kiddush? Who do you want them to have at the Shabbos table? How many more Yidden are going to be Shemit Torah and Mitzvahs because of you? What's a Raya Basheshana? The Moshe Zalevichik explained that there's a Raya Bekur, a shepherd that has a booming voice, and when the sheep stray, he hollers at them, yells at them to get back into line. There's a Raya Bamakiel, he has a staff, and he forces that into line. There's a sheepdog that nips at the sheep to get back in place. But then there's a Raya Basheshana. He has the fragrance, the aroma of succulent flowers, succulent aroma of these flowers, that when the sheep begin to stray, they smell those flowers, they come running back. We are the door of Raya Basheshana. It's not going to be with the booming voice, it's not going to be with the stick of a sheep's door. You have to bring them back. Basheshana. That's exactly what you are. The Sikos, the Arevis, the Ziskite, the Gishmakite, the Lebedekite, the Elchite, from good to Yidden. That's what brings them back. And they're coming back. Tens of thousands are coming back because of the fragrance of the homes. I'll tell you a story happened in Haifa a few years ago. There's in Haifa something called Chof Nifrad, separate time swimming for male and female. And the Mankal, the fellow in charge of the the chayf isn't very happy. Who wants it? Chof murav. Grill murav, chof murav. He wants everything murav. They're taking away his time. But it was a little time in the municipality of chayf, because of their chayin, said that part of the time, the public beach is going to be set in swimming. One day he shows up. It's the time for a chof nifrad. And he goes over to a boy. And he says, you'll have a pchad. I love you. Kid starts getting nervous. Lo, and says, yo, come on, I want to be like you. He really is getting nervous. And fishes into his pants, he pulls up here and sits us. And you'll let him sit. This is an Israeli kid. My pchad, that's it's yours. What's with you and the tzitzis? You're like Scrooge, you know, you're a tough guy. So he says like this, etmol there was a tunat drachim, he was stuck in a pkak in a traffic jam. And by the time he came to the beach, he was all messed up. Because the people in Haifa thought it was free day, no one collecting the 20 shkolim. So hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of people went swimming for free. By the time he came, it was late in the afternoon, and it was time for the nifrad. He goes, drives, parks his car. And he sees over 100 men and boys. They're standing on like the boardwalk, the patio, and no one put a foot onto the sand. They're waiting for him to come and collect the money. Now, they could have said he's not here, everybody else went, we'll pay when he comes. They held it was also to step on the beach until they pay. He says, I want to be like you. This is how I want to be. A bunch of kids would pay us, turn the guy into a shame of Shabbos because they wouldn't step on the beach without paying. I'll tell you another nice thing. What does it mean to be Raya Basheshana? There's a fellow who's very machbid, David Philip at Seaboy, he lives in England. He travels to Eretz Yisrael constantly. His plane was delayed. He arrived in his hotel room at 3 a.m. He had me at David Meyer. He runs the Zechut Moshe Shul for a minyan. And he sees one fellow there. He says, you think there's a minyan? He says, I don't know, there's me and you. We need 8 more. Takes out his cell phone. He starts calling Eisenbach Cab Company. And he says, I need tarif moniot. He gives the address of Zechut Moshe Shul. He needs 8 taxis. A few minutes later, 8 taxis gun up, and their engines are roaring. And they ask the guy, if one will see him, where are the passengers? No, can. This is like, it's like Mashiach time. Leave the camp with the meter running. He brings them in, and he says, I need something to tell him, I'll give him minyan. Look, it'll make us crazy. They didn't have yarmulkes. He gives them all yarmulkes. So Pama Bishon, Shani Bipalal, he shows money down the mire. Two fellas in Zephyr Moshe, eight cab drivers, they're down the mire. Listen to the mice. Mire's over. So he tells the people, I'm Zephyr Shalom Otchem. Chalapachot, Shivim Shkalim, 70 Shkolim, at least, maybe 100 Shkolim, each one. אני מוכן לשלם. First guy says, להתפלל עם צדיק כמוך, אני לא לוקח כוש. דבר, אבל זה... He's a taxi driver, ladies and gentlemen. In Israel. 10 שקולים extra, because you're putting suitcases in the trunk. What's the trunk for? Oh, it's Erev Shabbos, 20 שקל surcharge, I gotta buy flowers for my mother-in-law. And he goes on and on and on. What's going on? He's a taxi driver. Second fellow says, הפעם הראשון בחיים שפללתי מעריב, אני לא לוקח. Eight taxi drivers, nobody took the penny. That's Roya Bash Hashanah. Federation had a mission at the beginning of the Intifada. And he invited my Kehillah Beis Yisroel in Minneapolis to join him. I spoke to my Rebbeim, Chava Metzitz Gedele HaTera, and they said under certain conditions we should go. So here's the picture. 95 Minnesotans from Minneapolis and St. Paul went on a federation mission to the Chizuk Teretz Yisroel. 23 were from my Kehillah. I told them I need blood kosher, they had blood kosher tables. They took us to the Kaisel to Dab Kasikin every day. We stayed at the King David Hotel. That was a lot of fun. We went to a kibbutz. This is a beautiful resort kibbutz, which was shut down because they didn't find them, no tourists. So they plugged in the Ferris wheel for us. Three buses pull up, and I'm with a lot of different chevra. A lot of people that ultimately became Shevet Torah Mitzvahs joined the Kailah, Kehillah, sent the kids to Torah Academy because of this mission. I didn't know the commission was being Makara for people from Minnesota who were going with us. So the Menahelet of the kibbutz comes down the stairs. And she's like a wizened old lady, about 80 years old. And she says to me, Bevakasha lo lishtolelka. Tishayel b'makomot miyuchadot u'vakashel. And the Lord says she's stolen. I don't want you wandering around, making trouble over here. She tells me, sit in your seats that say Glad Kosher, don't go anyplace else. So I say, Aleichem Shalom. Thank you so much for the warm welcome. And so she hears, Shalom Aleichem, Aleichem Shalom. There's no moon, she's not Kiddush Levana. So she figures she's got to stick out her hand. So she sticks out her hand to me, I shake my hand. I don't give her my hand. Oh, Tosu, from those kinds of people. So I say to her, Atotzala dat lama nedo no ten yad? You wonder why I don't give you a hand? Betach, I'm your man. Atam mefachem minyani. You're scared of me. So I open my wallet, put out a picture of my wife, a beautiful picture of my wife, and I show it to her and I say, Ze ishti, at choshevet shet mefachem minyani. I'm scared of you, like the Wicked Witch of the West, I'm going to touch you, I'm going to melt, you think that's going to happen? So I tell her, At Watzal, At Zat, Lama, Nelun, Tehya, you wonder why I don't give you a hand? Lama, Ani mechabded otach, because I honor you. Because women are on a pedestal, they're not huggy, touchy, family, a wife, a mother, a child, a sister. But just to touch another woman, Ani mechabded otach. Oh. זה פעם הראשון שאני שומע דבר כזה. First time I hear something like that. And for the next 2 hours, I had a gabe. She was with me the entire time. רב צאצא, חמדל, קצ'ור, מה שרב צא, אני כאן. And listen to this, as we're walking back to the buses, she's walking with me. And she tells me, do you know why I was so angry at you when I saw you? Because I grew up in Meir Shalom. And then at 15, I ran away and I joined the leftists. And every time I see a religious Jew, hurts me. It hurts me. Ladies and gentlemen, these are my brothers and sisters. These are my brothers and sisters. A couple of years ago, the National Theatre of Eretz Yisrael of the State of Israel had a play that was shown to over 1 million Israelis. And the gist of it was that in Haifa, an elderly couple who had survived Auschwitz opened up a butcher store. They couldn't make a living, so they started selling basar lavan, the other white meat. And the Haredim, that's us, protested and made havgalot. And one Shabbos, a mishugana took a Molotov cocktail and threw it and burned down the shop. And unbeknownst to him, the couple was sleeping in the back. And he killed them. So what's the subliminal message? That they saved from the fires of the crematorium only to be killed by us, the Haredim. This is what we're fighting against. 1 million Israelis saw this play. But you know what? That same year a helicopter went down and 15 Israeli soldiers were killed. There were three families, Rahman al-San, Sid and Shiv and Gilad Zev, and they were complaining that how come you don't see religious boys in the army, a couple of Hezda boys, but you don't see the Ibn Taylor in the army. 18 venerable Hasidim of Karlin, stolen 70 and 80 year old Yidden, traveled by bus to Gilad Zev. And they sat down with these families and they just cried. They cried and they cried and they cried because these are our children too. These are my brothers and sisters. Now the matzahs might be bad, but there's an incredible Arachayim HaKadosh. You know, they have this Te'eva parade in Yerushalayim, unfortunately. Alternative lifestyle, Yiddish Kinder parading within walking distance of the Mekayim, HaMikdash, HaShvas, HaShvina, HaKadosh Baruch Hu. All our tefillahs are directed in that place. So you say to yourself, they're all so far gone. Baruch Haim HaKadosh, he says that Klal Yisrael had to run out of Mitzrayim b'chipazon because they were the 49th Shar Tumah. Had they tarried one nanosecond longer, they never would have been able to come out of the abyss. They would have been in the Nun Shar Tumah, and they never could have been redeemed. This is the Arachayim HaKadosh. If you look it up, it's Kapitul Gimel Pasuk Chav Ches. Pasuk Ches. He says that was before Matan Torah. Koyach HaTorah can climb out of Nun Shar Tumah. Some of our people are in Nun Shar Tumah, but there's nothing to be afraid of. Because at the end of the day, we have the Koyach HaTorah that we've always had. It's stronger than ever. That's what inspire is. It's to inspire Yidden with Torah, with Yira, with Chesed, with authentic Yiddishkeit, to overflow. And I want to just end with one story, because I think this is going to be a humorous story. Sometimes you walk past people and you say to yourself, what would the Chofetz Chaim say? What would the Chofetz Chaim do? I once saw a bunch of kids playing football on Shabbos in uniforms. I knew there were Jewish kids in a park. What would the Chofetz Chaim say? I can't tell you what the Chofetz Chaim would say, but I'll tell you what the Chofetz Chaim's Einikel did. His Einikel was Reb Herschel Zak Zatzal, a tremendous Talmud Chacham. Was a Rosh Kollel in Eretz Yisrael, and he happened to have a good sense of humor. He moved in Tavshin Lamed to Eretz Yisrael, 1970, and that's when they had the Ramot Road and all kinds of issues with Havganot. It was terrible. Yidden were driving specifically to Yatsanas in Jewish areas, and the Yidden were getting upset, throwing rocks. It was a terrible scene. So Herschel Zak had recently come from America. He turns to Fred and he says, you know what, let's do something about this. What, more rocks? Bigger rocks? No, I have an idea. Let's go down to the Hafgana, and we'll memorize a license plate. We'll go tomorrow, Sunday, to the area, and we'll find out who it belongs to the car, and we'll go talk to them and reason with them not to drive on Shabbos in our neighborhood. So they went down, they memorized a license plate. In those days, you can do it. They went to the area, and they found out where the person lived. He lived in Ramot. Teddy Kollek's dream, Ramot should be Haredi rhyme. The only problem is Ramot, Mount, Beis, Gimel, Dalet, Hei, Vav, Zayin, Tov, only from the Yidden. And that's the bottom line. So they come to Ramot, these were the early days of the Ramot. And they're knocking on the door, and the door opens up, a little kid opens the door, and he had a television blaring from the back. And the kid takes one look at Rabbi Zaks and his friend, and he says, Abba, השחורים הגיעו. The black guys, that's us. Well, you know, in our world, the black guys went white. I mean, we're the good guys went black. But anyway, השחורים הגיעו. So the father sits in the back over the dinner and tells his son, תן להם לירה. Give me a dollar. So, באמת, ברצינות, אנחנו רוצים לדבר עם אביך. We really want to talk to your father. אבא, באמת, רוצים אותך. תן להם עוד לירה. לא, לא, רוצים אותך. So, daddy, you know, he pads out with slippers over there. מה אתם רוצים? What do you want? What are you bothering me? So, Zax, who had a perfect command of Hebrew language, says, שלום, עכשיו אני הגעתי מארצות הברית. ושמה בארצות הברית שמרסי עשה שבועס. למה כאן עכשיו אני לא יכול לשמור את השבועס? למה אתה נוהג? אתה מפריע את השבועס שלי. The man looks like some planet Xena. He tells him, Harav, ata tzedek. You're right. Mikan la'ban, I don't understand Yerushalayim. He says, Chof Hayam, I'm going to go to Eilat, I'm going to go to the Yerushalayim. I'm not going to bother him anymore. End of story. Now for the rest of the story. 2 years later, Zax gets an invitation in the mail to Bar Mitzvah. Doesn't know what it is. It's Israel. He goes. He arrives and he says, Bar Mitzvah, what day is? Doesn't know who the kid is. All of a sudden, the man comes running over and he says, Arab, at Arab, lo zocher oti. Hayiti oto barnash, Arab, biker oti, ma televizye, shama, kishanahakti, bekiyat zanz. I said to myself, and to my wife, if they care so much about me that they're willing to come and explain themselves to me, maybe there's something special to these people. And I put my kid into a Torani school, we became Shomrei Shabbat, and this is Bar Mitzvah. Now, the version of our health, and we should all be zeichet b'siyata d'shmaya, to continue to be mevakshei Hashem, to have that bria chaticha, to be overflowing with Torah and mitzvahs, to be secure in our Yiddishkeit, to bring others closer to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, when you never know who's being the car of who. Here's the Yitzchak of Lubavitch Hatzal, the Friedrich Rebbe Hatzal used to say, it is like the word kiruv. Because you don't know who's closer to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And the process, we all become closer. That wonderful day will be zeichet to be as a girl in the area. Oh.